طيب، بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Welcome in day 8 of Young Muslim Program Summer Edition. And we start first with the ibadah, the worship. And we will discuss tonight sajdat al-tilawa, sujood al-tilawa, or prostration of recitation. As you know, when you read the Quran, there are some verses in the Quran that a sign shows that you have to do sujood, sajda. Let us see what is the ruling of sajdat al-tilawa and how can we practice sajdat al-tilawa according to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sunnah. طيب. There are 15 spot in the Quran there is a sign of sujood al-tilawa. How many? 15. 15. The first one in Surah Al-A'raf. What is the first sajda in Quran? Surah Al-A'raf. And the last sajda, Surah Al-Alaq. And they are in between سورة الرعد، سورة النحل، سورة الإسراء، سورة مريم، سورة الحج have two، سورة الفرقان، سورة النمل، سورة السجدة، and سورة صاد، and سورة فصلت، and سورة النجم، and سورة الانشقاق، and then last one is سورة العلق. خلاص؟ This is how many سجد التلاوة in Quran 15. What is the first one? سورة الأعراف. What is the last one? العلق. Okay. طيب, what is the condition of سجدة التلاوة? And as you can see, there is a sign showed that there is a سجود تلاوة here. Do you know this sign? When you see in the Quran, it means that you do سجدة التلاوة. First condition of سجود التلاوة, any action should have intention. Is that correct? Action is judged by intention. Second, you have to purity of the body, purity of the clothes, and the place of sujood, clean place. And also because this is a sajda, which is a part of salah, kind of salah, you have to cover your awra, and then facing the qibla. So this is the condition. However, some opinions said that it's not necessary to have a wudu of sujood tilawa. But the majority of scholars said it is like any salah, you have to have wudu. What about if you are in a bus or a tram or a train and you read Quran and there is a spot of Quran sajda? What you should do? Can you do sajda while you are there, or you have to delay it until you go to your house and then do sajda? What do you think? Huh? You can do, but instead of prostration normally, just indicate with your move your head like. Yeah, while you're sitting, you can do, yes, you can do that, of course. So this is sujood al-tilawa. So far, it is optional or mustahab, recommended. And the other opinion, it is wajib, obligatory. So we have two opinions of a scholar. It is wajib, means obligatory, you have to do it. And the other opinion, which is recommended or mustahab, which is more closer to the correct. It is not compulsory. It is recommended or mustahab. خلاص. Then we go to سيرة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The سيرة. And we will stop last time when Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم asked the Sahaba to migrate to Al-Habasha in Abyssinia. And some of the Sahaba went there like Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, Uthman ibn Affan, Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, Az-Zubayr ibn Al-Awwam. All these fives went to the Al-Habasha, which the first immigration in Islam was in Habasha. Then Quraysh didn't leave them. They sent behind them Amr ibn Al-As to speak with the king of the Habasha, his name is An-Najashi, to return them to Mecca. But Ja'far ibn Abi Talib debate with Amr ibn al-As in front of the Al-Najashi, and the Najashi refused to return them to Mecca and give them the security and protection. Then we explain in the sixth years after بعثة, after revelation, his uncle Hamza accepted Islam. And on the 7 years after revelation, Quraysh isolated the Muslim in a place called Shi'ab Abi Talib, the branches of Abi Talib. And they stopped giving them food and drink and stopped any relation between them. And spent about 3 years inside this Shu'ab Abi Talib. And then in the year 10 after revelation, the uncle of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, Abu Talib, passed away. And then the same year, Sayyidah Khadija passed away. And then Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, in year 12, he went after Hijrah, after revelation, he went to At-Ta'if and they refused to accept Islam. Not only that, they sent the boys and the foolish people behind him and throw him with the stones and he bleed from his body. Subhanallah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then 1 year before the Hijrah, in the 12th year, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa in Al-Isra and Mi'raj. And as we know, in this journey, the Abu Bakr al-Siddiq believed what he mentioned to Quraysh, and because of that, since this day, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq has the kunya al-Siddiq because he believed his story of going to Al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Then on the same year, the 12th, remember, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the season of Hajj, which season? Hajj. He used to speak with the people who comes to Mecca for Hajj. And he met with 12 people from Al-Ansar. Who's Ansar, by the way? Yes, the people of Medina, the helpers, Ahsant. 12 of people of Medina met in a place called Al-Aqaba. What's the place called? Al-Aqaba. And they gave to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam bleach to support him and protect him. And this called the bleach of Aqaba, the first bleach of Aqaba. How many people were there? 12. The next year, which is the 13th after revelation, imagine after first one was 12, now 70 men and 2 women. So overall 72. Give the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam the second bleach of Aqaba. So how many people were there in the second? 72. The first one, 12. They give him the bleach to support him and protect him. And then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded him to migrate to Al-Madinah. Khalas? Then Quraysh tried to prevent some of the Sahaba from migration to Medina. One of the Sahaba, his name Suhaib al-Rumi. Suhaib al-Rumi, Suhaib is from Roman background, and he left all of his money for them to let him go to Medina. Look how he sacrificed all the money he has, gave it to Quraysh in order to let him leave Mecca toward Medina. And then, as you know, the story of the Hijrah, Quraysh collected about 10 strong people from each tribe to kill Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but they didn't see him, and he put some dust on the front in the faces, and they cannot see him, and he left and keep Ali ibn Abi Talib in his bed, as you know the story. And that traveling from Mecca to Medina is very hard. Imagine 30 or 360 kilometers between Mecca and Medina. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam struggled with his companion Abu Bakr in traveling to Medina. So how many kilometers between Mecca and Medina? 360 kilometers. طيب. Then the first year of the Hijrah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam brings all of his family, all of his daughters and the wives, his wife in this time, her name is Sauda bint Zam'a, and except only one daughter. So only one daughter of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam stayed in Mecca with her husband Al-As, because he was still a disbeliever, and she isolated and holded in the Mecca. Her name is Zainab. So all of the daughters of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Medina except whom? Zainab. طيب. And then the Salah has been prescribed on this year, and it was 2 rak'at in the residency and in the travel. So initially the salah was 2 rak'ah. Even you are in home, you pray Zuhr 2 rak'ah and Asr 2 rak'ah. This is at the beginning. And then after it we keep 2 in the travel and 4 during residency. In this year, which is the first year of Hijrah, the first boy born in Islam after Hijrah from the Muhajirin, his name is Abdullah ibn Zubayr. Remember this name. Abdullah ibn Zubayr, the first boy who born in Medina after migration. And the first boy from Ansar who born, his name is An-Nu'man ibn Bashir. So we have two boys born in Medina after migration. First one from Muhajirin, the immigrant, his name is Abdullah ibn Zubayr. And the second one from Ansar, his name is An-Nu'man ibn Bashir. Khalas? And then on the Ramadan of this month, the jihad or the striving has been prescribed on the Muslim. And the first battle Prophet Muhammad sent was led by Hamza, his uncle. Hamza ibn Abdul Muttalib, his uncle. Khalas? So this is the seerah lesson. Let us go to hadith lesson. Today's hadith is very important, because it shows how can you fulfill your completion of Iman. Can you listen, please? Ibrahima, listen, please. Yes. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت ومن كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم جاره ومن كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليكرم ضيفه. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه mentioned that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, let him who believes in Allah on the last day speak good or keep silent. And let him who believes in Allah on the last day be generous to his neighbor. And let him who believes in Allah on the last day be generous to his guest. So we have here three characters of the Muslim. If you believe in Allah on the last day, you have to fulfill these three characters. First, speak good or keep silent. As I can see, some of you speak something not necessary. So it is recommended to keep silent. Because if you don't say something good, keep silent. And then one statement said, if speech from silver, silent will be from gold. And the speech, if you speak, you cannot return your speech. Once you mention the word, can you return it back? It's khalas, finish. So also one of the attributes of the believer is to be generous with the neighbor. The Muslim neighbor and the non-Muslim neighbor, doesn't matter. You have to be kind and generous with your neighbor. Don't make noise in the night and don't distract their life and be quiet with them and always in your Eid or your celebration, bring them some food as a kind of da'wah to invite them for Islam. Even the non-Muslim, yes, you can.
What if they give you something and it's haram?
In this case, you cannot eat, just take it from them and then throw it, but you don't eat it. Or you can explain to him or them, my deen or my religion prohibit to eat, for example, ham or eat pig, but you have to explain to him. And then the last one, to be generous with your guest. If you invite someone to your house, you have to be generous. And by the way, you have responsibility toward your guest to give him food for 3 days. How many days?
3 days.
This is responsibility. If you have some guest came to your house, stay with you for 3 days, you have to provide him food. The first day, the best that you can, best of the best. The second and third, the normal food that you eat with your family.
What if you don't
The same. If they came by themselves without invitation, in Islam, you have the right to tell them, I don't have time to accept you, come another time. This is Islamically, by the way. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ رِجِعُوا فَرْجِعُوا And if they mention to them return, they will return. So that means, if you go to someone's house without invitation, without notes, he have the full rights to tell you, I don't have time now, please come later. It's Islamically, it's not haram to do that. خلاص? But once he enters your house as a guest, you have to give him food for 3 days. The first day is the best food that you have, and the normal food in the second and the third. And after that, just it is optional for you if you want to give him food or say, خلاص, no food after that, up to you. But at least, by the way, the guest should not stay more than 3 days. At least he can stay if there is necessity, but 3 days is the minimum or the maximum days that the person stayed with his. Which one? What? Sorry.
Roommate.
What do you mean? Was a roommate? Man.
Like, legend.
Nah.
Basically, dividing the house, but like,
yeah, that's how someone lives with you.
With you. We don't have that in Islam. We only have the guest or family member. That's it. Nothing more than that. خلاص خلاص. Okay. I think we cover today. Be quiet when you start the Kahoot. Yes, please. But sit here, just in case. Yes.
Mm.
Ready? Start, y'all.
I'll get it right. I'll get it right.
Still loading. Yalla, get ready for the bin number. Yalla, 6602901. 6602901. Sorry? This one? You wanna cancel? This one?
No, that's mine.
I'm going to cancel it. So there are two Faris. So, I'm the Faris, huh? Min Sayyid. I cancel يعني? طيب. Or we can say. يلا خش اطلع خش تاني 15 و ريدي يلا 66029 خلاص I'm waiting.
معلش يا دكتور ممكن تديت فارس برضو
فارس ده كده فارس يعني؟
اه فارس
خلاص شلته.
Who's copying us all
6-6-0-2-9. خلاص ready؟ بسم الله. Can you be quiet please? Be quiet please. Day 8. Wait. The first bridge of Al-Aqaba was in 12 years after beginning of Revelation, 8 years after beginning, 10 years, 1 year. Be quiet while you're answering. 12. Number two, the first bridge of Al-Aqaba was in the season of fasting, Hajj, Zakah, prayer. So the code is 6-6-0-2-9-0-1. How many people from Ansar attended first bridge of Al-Aqaba? 10, 12, 72, 6. The first one.
I got it wrong.
It was 12.
It was 12.
What did you do?
12.
Sorry.
No, yes.
Number four. Who left his money to Quraysh to let him immigrate? Who's the Sahabi who left his... Ali ibn Abi Talib, Suhaib al-Rumi, Umar ibn Khattab, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Suhaib al-Rumi. Number five. After... Be quiet, Habibi. After immigration, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam bring his family except his daughter Fatima, his daughter Zainab, his wife Sauda, his daughter Umm Kulthum. Easy, easy. His daughter Zainab. Number six. The prayer was prescribed initially as how many rak'ah in residency and travel, initially. 2, 5, 4, 3. In the beginning. Two, of course. At the beginning was two. The first boy born from Muhajirin is Abdullah ibn Zubair, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Amr, An-Nu'man ibn Bashir. From Muhajirin. Abdullah ibn Zubair. The first boy born from Ansar is Abdullah ibn Zubair, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Amr, An-Nu'man ibn Bashir. Number nine. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent in the first battle in Islam سنت علي بن أبي طالب حمزة بن عبد المطلب عبد الله بن عمر عمر بن الخطاب. He sent his uncle حمزة. ما شاء الله. Very close. According to today's hadith, sign of believer. Speak good or remain silent. Be generous with the guest. Be generous with the neighbor. All of the above. You have to be quiet. You need to think about it before you answer, huh? Number. According to today's hadith, how many sign of believer? 2, 4, 3, 6. 3. How many days you should host your guest? 3, 2, 4, 6. Three days. The first sujood al-tilawa in Surah Al-Nas, Al-A'raf, Al-Najm, Al-Ra'd. Al-A'raf. The number of sujood tilawa is 15, 10, 16, 11. Having wudu for sujood tilawa is wajib, mustahab, optional, different opinions. Different. You have to think it. We have two opinions. Number 16. How many condition of sujood tilawa? How many condition? 4, 2, 3, 5. Four. How many condition again? Repeat again, yalla.
Easy.
Yalla. Number 18. Select the sign of sujood tilawa. Which one of these signs sujood tilawa? Wait. It will upload now. How do you know? It's supposed to be loaded. Sorry?
The photo showed up in the phone.
Oh. So it showed in the... Do you see the sign? Do you see the?
Yeah.
It was there, but not here. Yalla, 19. There is agreement between all mazahib about how many sajda. 15, 14, 12, 10. No, 15. No agreement. They less than 15. 10. Last one. There is no agreement between all mazhab about sajda. How many sajda? There is no agreement. There are 10 agreement and all 15, so the rest is 5. So let us see who the third. Tasneem, the third. Second, Muhammad Hamza. And first one. MashaAllah. Safe, MashaAllah. Barakallah feekum. By the way, wait, boys and girls. Just this coming Sunday, we will have the sport and the cooking and fun activity in the park this Sunday. Santa Clara Park. It will on 5:30. Oh, everything, inshallah. But you have to register, inshallah.